Anonymous asks, I transferred my Bitcoin with too low a fee, and it's been unconfirmed for 10 days. What should I do? First of all, do not fret. You didn't actually transfer your Bitcoin. You still have your Bitcoin. A Bitcoin transaction either happens and is confirmed, and confirmed several times, or it doesn't. And if it doesn't get confirmed, it hasn't happened. And if it does get confirmed, it has happened. Now, it sounds like I'm speaking in mystical riddles, but the bottom line is, we call this principle in distributed systems atomicity. Atomicity means it is an indivisible operation. Either it all happens or it doesn't. It's not as if the Bitcoin left your address and then exists in some kind of limbo state and then has not yet landed in the other address. The transaction that makes it leave your address hasn't been confirmed, which is why it hasn't arrived at the other address. But it also means it hasn't left your address. And if that transaction does get confirmed, at the very moment that it arrives in the other address, because it never really moved, it is also no longer available for you to spend. So either the transaction has happened, and that money is already owned by the recipient, or it hasn't, and it's still owned by you. Now, your wallet may hide this from you. For usability purposes, your wallet will not let you basically create another transaction spending that Bitcoin that has not yet been confirmed in this transaction. And your wallet is doing that to prevent an accidental double spend attempt or confusion by wallet users. But the bottom line is that the money is still in your wallet. You just can't control it, which means you should get a better wallet. So first of all, the idea that you did a transaction and that transaction had insufficient fee tells me that you do not have a wallet that allows you to increase the fee after a transaction has been broadcast. Wallets that allow you to do that support one of two technologies. One is called replace by fee, which allows you to broadcast a second transaction with increased fee. And the other one is a technology called child pays for parent, which allows you to make another transaction with the change, or even allows the merchant or recipient to make another transaction with the payment amount that is a child transaction that has more fee, and that child fee is enough to pay for the parent fee, causing both the child and the parent to be confirmed simultaneously. So all of this is stuff that you can do with a more sophisticated wallet, but it can be confusing, especially if your wallet is not sophisticated, and it can lead you to both getting stuck where you can't make a transaction you want to make, and worse, help you, or rather put you in a situation of fear or confusion or even panic. Like, where's my money? Your money is exactly where it always was. So don't worry, first of all. And there's probably nothing you can do with your current wallet to fix this. You have to be patient. Eventually, the backlog will clear and the transaction will get kicked out of the blockchain. I think the maximum amount of time that a transaction is held in the mempool by any client is 14 days. So you might only be 3 days away from getting that fixed. The transaction will simply get dropped. And at that point, I would say the first transaction you need to make is to a better wallet.
I hope you enjoyed that video. If you'd like to support me in my mission of educating people about Bitcoin and open blockchains all around the world and publishing free content under Creative Commons licenses, please consider subscribing to the channel, sharing this video, as well as supporting me on patreon.com/aantonop. Thank you.